Good morning, all of you. Welcome back to the class. In this today's session, we are going to understand the concept of compound angles and related identities based on which we are going to solve some important questions, or you can also speak, they are the basically trigonometric identities which are introducing as a questions in the exercise 3.3 in NCERT. So let's have a concept, have a discussion on compound angles. What is meant by compound angle first? If any angle is expressible as sum of two angles, or there is an angle X which can be written as difference of two angles. Just try to understand, if an angle is expressible as sum of two angles or difference of two angles, then that angles are called what? Compound angles. Let us say, if I want to express 75 degree as a compound angle, so I can write it as 45 degree plus 30 degree. Right. Similarly, if I want to write 135 degree, so I could write this as 180 degree minus 45 degree. So if I am able to write this the given angle as a sum or a difference of standard angles, sum or difference of standard angle, then I could say, yes, these angles are compound angles, and based on this concept, we can develop few identities where we could able to find the ratios of compound angles, right? So now we are going to understand the formulas where sine of a plus b or x plus y, sine of x minus y, cos of x plus y, cos of x minus y, tan of x plus y and tan of x minus y. These six basic formulas which we are going to introduce, not in the detailed derivation part, only the outline part we'll discuss, and based on which we'll see the more application of these identities in the questions. The first and the most important formula, I am directly writing this without the derivation. You can just remember this, it's sufficient to apply. Sine of x plus y. Sine of x plus y. See, you can hear x and y are two angles which are expressible as the addition of two angles. So this x plus y is commonly known as compound angles. Okay, so sine of x plus y can be expanded as sine x into cos y plus cos x into sine y. So this compound angle can be expanded like this, even vice versa, you can say. The expanded form can reduce to a shortest form. So LHS can be written as RHS, then RHS can reduce as LHS. Without discussing the derivation over here, just I am writing the formulas here, based on which we can discuss the questions which are more useful to us. Then cos of x, I will also write sine of x minus y pairwise. Sine of x minus y. Simply to get the formula of sine of x minus y, just what we need to do, just in place of y, just we need to replace minus y. So when I replace minus y in the above formula, you can see cos of minus y is cos y only, but sine of minus y becomes minus sine y. Hence, the middle sign will interchange. Rest identity will remain same. So, hence, the formula becomes sin x into cos y minus cos x into sin y. These are the first set of formula, you can see. The second set is related to cos. Similarly, cos of x plus y is equal to cos x cos y minus sin x into sin y. Cos of x minus y is equal to, just the formula, again the remain same, only sign will interchange, that is the middlemost sign is interchanged, sin x into sin y. Simply by replacing this y with minus y, you will be able to write this identity. So basically, these are the four identities of compound angles. Compound means addition or difference of two angles. So this is basically, these formulas will be useful to write the sine of 75 degrees, sine of 105 degree, which are the multiples of 15. That we will discuss later on. Now, the next is tan. Only we require sine, cos and tan. So, sine of x plus y is basically written as tan x plus tan y upon 1 minus tan x into tan y. So this is again the right formula. Tan of x plus y can written as sine of x plus y by sine of x minus y. Then by expanding them, then by doing some modifications, we are able to get this formula. Now the last formula is tan of x minus y is equal to tan x minus tan y upon 1 plus tan x into tan y. But while defining these formulas, tan of x plus y and tan of x minus y, we must remember x and y, these both the angles cannot be a right multiple of x and y cannot be a multiples of pi by 2 or multiples of pi by 2, right? Because tan 90 is not defined, like tan 270 is also not defined like this. Tan pi by 2, tan 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 7 pi by 2, 9 pi by 2, 11 pi by 2 are not defined. Hence, while applying the formula of tan, remember, x and y cannot be the odd multiples of pi by 2. Right? Based on this condition, you can use these formulas. But while applying sine and cos, there is no condition on the angles, because for every angle of x and y, sine and cos are defined. Hence, there is no condition for sine and cos, but the condition is applicable on tan. So these are the basic six fundamental formulas which will counted as the T ratios of compound angle identities, right? So based on these identities, we are going to solve three types of questions, how these formulas can be useful, right? As you know that 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree, 270 degree and 360 degree. These are basically called standard angles, where you can simply find out, or you can simply use these values to solve the questions, right? So you may also speak these degree radian, degree measures in radian terms. 0 radian, pi by 6, pi by 4, pi by 3, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi. So you can also speak them in radian terms or in degree terms. Whenever these standard angles are there in the question, you will be able to substitute their values to simplify. Sir, what else if some angles are coming in between these angles? Like 75 degree. I want to find sine of 75 degree. I want to find cos of 135 degree. I want to find tan of 105 degree. How could I find these angles, right? How could I find these angles, right, where these angles are not in the standard table of trigonometric ratios? So here, if we observe, these angles basically expressible as the sum or difference of standard angles. Sum or difference of standard angles, like 75 can be written as 45 plus 30, where 45 and 30 are the standard angles. Similarly, 135 can be written as 90 plus 45. See, 90 plus 45 are the two standard angles. Similarly, 105 degree, which can be written as 60 plus 45, so 60 and 45 combination. Here, wherever the angles, which are basically the multiples of 15, remember, which are basically the multiples of 15 degree, right? So wherever the angles are basically multiples of 15 apart from the standard angles, right, we can express them in terms of the standard angles, or either they are the sum or the difference of that standard angles. Once we express these angles as a compound angles, then you can use these formulas to find their values. So let's have a discussion over that first. This is one of the most important application of compound angles identities. Now, how to solve this sine 75 first? I am taking this question. Right. Sine of 75 degree can be written as sine of 45 degree plus 30 degree, or 30 plus 45, anyway you can speak. Right. Now this is a multiple of 15, 15 5 is a 75. So I would able to write this multiple of 15 as a compound angle. Then I can use compound angle formula of sine of x plus y. This will be treated as x angle, this will be treated as y angle. Then I can use sine of x plus y formula to expand, right? So I am using that formula here to expand. So it becomes what? Sine x. Sine x means sine 45 degree into cos 30 degree plus cos 45 degree into sine 30 degree. That's it. So I would able to expand this sine 75 degree as like this. So what is the use of this in writing like expansion form? If you see the angles, these angles now converted into standard angles where you can directly substitute their values. Here, sine 45 value is 1 by root 2. Cos 30 value is root 3 by 2 plus sine cos 45 is 1 by root 2. sin 30 is 1 by 3. So finally, what you are able to write? 1 into root 3 is root 3 by 2 root 2 plus 1 by 2 root 2. Now you could take LCM as 2 root 2. The numerator is root 3 plus 1. So finally, the answer is root 3 plus 1 by 2 root 2. Now sin 75 degree value you have derived. So you can remember these values as a standard value for further algebraic treatment, you can say. Right? In a similar manner, we are going to find cos 135 degree by using the cos formula, tan 105 degree by using the tan formula. Okay? So, here I am taking the second part, that is cos 135 degree. This one. So, cos 135 degree. Now, if you observe this angle, this is basically a multiple of 15. 15 sevens are 105, 15 eights are 135, like this. So, here, so it's a multiple of 15, 15 nines are 135. So, 15 nines are 135 is a multiple of 15. So, hence, this angle can be written as sum or difference of standard angles. Okay, so wherever it is possible, we are going to use a compound angle formula to solve this question, right? Now, 135 can be written as a sum also it is possible, as a difference also possible. So, but purposely I would like to write as a difference here 180 minus 45 degree, just to use this formula. You may also write 90 plus 45, which would be easy for you, right? Wo bhi aap likh sakte ho, 90 plus 45 se bhi kar sakte ho, 180 minus 45 se bhi kar sakte ho. There are two ways to solve, but answer would be remain same. So, if you want to write the positive compound angles addition, if you like most, so you can go with that. I would also write 90 plus 45, both will work, no issue. Then, now it is in the form of cos of x plus y. So, use this cos of x plus y formula. In this way, cos x cos y minus sin x sin y. So, cos 90 into sine 45 degree minus sine 90 into cos 45 degree. What is the value of cos 90? Cos 90 value is 0 into 1 by root 2 minus sin 90 value is 1 into cos 45 is 1 value. So ultimately this will be 0 and we are left with minus 1 by root 2. So you are able to find the value of cos 135 as minus 1 by root 2 with the help of these compound angles formulas, or you can also say identities, right? So in a similar manner, you may also find tan of 105 degree. You could say tan of 105 degree with the help of tan formula, nothing else. Tan of, what was that? 105 degree. Okay, so this can be written as tan of 60 plus 45 degree. Okay, 60 degree plus 45 degree. So it is in the form of tan of A plus B. So I can use this formula to find its value. So tan of A plus B means tan A. Yeah, tan of x plus y, tan x plus tan y upon 1 minus tan x into tan y. Just in place of x, I have written 60. In place of y, I have written 45 in the rest formula. And then substitute. See, now you can see this angle, the multiple of 15 is converted into a standard angles, where you know the value of tan 60 directly. So tan 60 will be root 3. Tan 45 will be 1 upon 1 minus root 3 into 1. This is a product. It's a product. Now, you can also write root 3 plus 1, also written as 1 plus root 3 upon, you are left with 1 minus root 3. So, this is what the value you got, but we are having under root terms in the denominator. We need to rationalize the denominator to get the simplified one. So, that's why here the more simplification is required. Because we never leave the irrational numbers in the denominator. So now if you multiply both the factors, a plus b into a plus b the whole square. So 1 plus root 3 the whole square upon a minus b into a plus b form. So a square minus b square. Just simplify further. A plus b whole square entity, if you are using a square plus b square plus 2ab upon, if you observe here, square would get cancelled, 1 minus 3. The final answer would be 1 plus 3, here also square would get cancelled, 2 root 3 by minus 2. You may also write it as 4 plus 2 root 3 by minus 2. You may take 2 as a common factor from numerator. The final answer would be minus of 2 plus root 3. So this is your final answer. So here you can understand the use of these formulas. The fundamental use of these formulas is just to find the value of t ratio of the angles which are the basically a multiples of 15. That angles can be written as the sum or difference of these standard angles, where you can use this compound angle formulas to find those values. So this is the fundamental use of compound angle identities. Now, based on this, most of the sums are framed in the exercise 3.3 from question number 1 to question number 10. So, I would like to take few sums to understand how you can use these formulas to prove such questions. I'm checking these questions over here. This is from NCERT itself. Exercise 3.3. Question number 1 to question number 10. You can solve based on these identities. Remember, so out of these 10 sums, right? I'm checking few sums where you can apply these formulas and all. Here, I would like to take the question number 6. So, you can see cos of pi by 4 minus x into cos of pi by 4 minus 1 minus sine of pi by 4 minus x into sine of pi by 4 minus y, which you need to prove it as sine of x plus y. In 10th standard, you are practicing lot many questions to prove the trigonometric identities. Similarly, here also we are having few questions where you need to prove LHS is equal to RHS. To prove LHS is equal to RHS, we are taking left hand side part of the question. If you observe the left hand side part of the question, we are having some similar angles. See, pi by 4 minus x, pi by 4 minus x. Pi by 4 minus y, pi by 4 minus y. So, if you assume this pi by 4 minus x as a, so this would be a then. Yeah, if you observe, if you assume this as b, this would be becomes b. So, if let assume pi by 4 minus x as a and pi by 4 minus x as b, then how this entire expression is reduced? Just try to write this step. Cos a into cos b minus sin a into sin b. So, which would be in the form of cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. This expanded form can be reduced as cos of a plus b. So, in the next step, it can be reduced to cos of a plus b. Now then again, substitute the value of a and b with their original values. So, cos of pi by 4 minus x plus pi by 4, I think it is y. Pi by 4 minus y. So, now you can just group the like terms, like pi by 4 plus pi by 4 will become pi by 2. 45 plus 45, 90, minus x minus y. Now, I can write it as pi by 2 minus 4. I can take minus common here. Now, if you observe this step here, cos of 90 minus theta is sine theta. Already you have studied these t ratios of complementary angles in 10th standard. Sine of 90 minus theta is cos theta. Cos of 90 minus theta is sine theta. So here it is in the form of cos of 90 minus theta. This completely theta, right? So it reduces to what? Sine theta. I think we arrived the answer. We started with left hand side and we arrived the right hand side part with the help of which formula? Compound angle formula. So, in the exercise 3.3 from question number 1 to 10, basically these questions are framed based on these 6 formulas only. So, with the help of this, you will be able to find these all questions, you will be able to prove these all identities as LHS equal to RHS. Now, in a similar way, I am taking one more question to understand the concept and how to use these identities to prove in such a manner. I would like to take question number 10. Randomly I am picking. Sine of, we have to prove, show that sine of n plus 1 times of x into sine of n plus 2 times of x plus cos of n plus 1 times of x into cos of n plus 2 times of x is equal to cos x. We have to prove this LHS is equal to RHS. Again, it's so simple. If you observe, again they are having a similar angles, n plus 1 into x, n plus 1 into x, n plus 2 into x, n plus 2 into x. So if you assume this n plus 1 into x as a, so this would be a then. If we assume this angle as b, so this would be b. So what I am taking here, left hand side portion, before applying the formula, I am simply writing this complicated angles n plus 1 into x as a and n plus 2 into x as b. If I am writing this, this entire expression looks so simple and you will be able to get an idea which identity is going to be used to reduce it. So it reduces to what? Sine A into sine B plus cos A into cos B. So now you can see it is just following the identity of cos of x minus y. Sin A sin B plus cos A cos B. Addition mein aap kaise bhi use kar sakte ho, sin pair likhkar cos piche bhi likh sakte ho. Addition is commutative. Okay. So now this is basically reduced to which formula? The fourth formula, cos of x minus y formula. So it reduced to cos of A minus B formula. Okay, so hence now once it is reduced to a single t ratio, then I would say substitute these A and B original values. So what is the value of A? We have n plus 1 into x minus value of B is n plus 2 into x. That's it. And then simply solve. Multiply with x inside, here it becomes minus nx minus 2x plus nx minus nx get cancelled. Cos of x minus 2x is minus x, but we know cos of minus x is cos x because negative angle, negative acute angle lies in the fourth quadrant. In a fourth quadrant, cos theta is always positive. Cos of minus x is cos x. Hence, we got the RHS. See, we are able to prove, right, the identity LHS is equal to RHS. So, this is the use of this compound angles. Based on these compound angles, they have trained three questions for practice purpose. Just by keeping this complicated angle as simplest ABC language, you will be able to identify which identity is going to be used to reduce them into a single T ratio. So these identities may be used as, like, for expansion are to reduce into single T ratio, vice versa case. आप LHS का यूज करके उसको एक्सपांड कर सकते हो, एक्सपांडेड फॉर्म को आप सिंगल टी रेशियो में कन्वर्ट भी कर सकते हो, डिपेंडिंग ऑन दी क्वेश्चन बेसिकली, राइट। चलिए नाउ टेक दी वन मोर क्वेश्चन वेयर वी कैन सी द यूज ऑफ टैन फॉर्मुलास, राइट। So I'm taking question number 7 over here. Question number 7. We have to prove that tan of pi by 4 plus x upon tan of pi by 4 minus x is equal to 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x the whole square. See, again we can take left hand side part to prove right hand side part. LHS leke hum RHS proof kar sakte. But if we observe the LHS, we are having the numerator part as tan of x plus y form. Tan of x plus y form. Similarly, in the denominator, we are having tan of x minus y form. So we are going to use both the formulas in the same question. Right? So first, I will solve the numerator part. Yeah, you can also carry with the question directly. So I am taking the left hand side of the question. In the first numerator, I am going to use this formula to expand like this. So I am able to write the numerator as tan of, right, in place of x, what we have, pi by 4, in place of y, x. Just substitute these values in this formula. Let's expand this one. Tan of pi by 4 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan of pi by 4 into tan x. This is the numerator part upon denominator part. What is the denominator part we have? Tan of a x minus y formula. Right? We use that one. So tan A minus tan B upon 1 plus tan A into tan B. That's it. As you know that tan of pi by 4, that is 45 degree, its value is 1. So, wherever tan pi by 4 is there, substitute its value as 1. So, this become 1. So, now the reduced to what? If this is 1. So, 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x, because if this is 1, so 1 into tan x, only tan x. Numerator part is done. Denominator. 1 minus tan x upon, here it is 1, 1 into tan x is tan x only, so 1 plus tan x. Now, this is fraction upon fraction, then to simplify you can reciprocal it. So, if you reciprocal it, what we are going to get, see, 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x into, if you reciprocal this, you are able to get the same expression. 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x. It's basically having the same, what we called as basis. So, x into x form is x square. So, hence, we can write it as 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x the whole square, which we got the right hand side part which is desired. It's so simple, very easy and fully thrilling questions. It looks like a complicated one, but when you apply these formulas, that expression is reduced to very simple formulas or simple expressions, right? You could see we have taken left hand side part. Right, and we have applied the formulas here and just to reduce the RHS. So, left hand side is equal to right hand side, hence this identity is proven. Now, I would like to take the next one, that is the last question of today's discussion. Now you can see. The question is like question number 8. Cos of 5 plus x into cos of minus x upon sine of pi minus x into cos of pi by 2 plus x, which where we have to prove it is equal to cot squared. There are several ways to solve this question. The student may use the formula of cos of a plus b, cos of a plus b, to expand this and to find the value. Or you can directly know that cos of 180 plus theta, 180 plus theta will come in third quadrant. You know that. You already studied all silver teacups and the quadrant angles pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. So these are called quadrant angles. If you read the angle as pi plus x means amount of rotation is pi plus x means it comes in the third quadrant. So basically pi plus x and 3 pi by 2 minus x, these are angles always counted in the third quadrant. Similarly, here you can also say 3 pi by 2 plus x or 2 pi minus x, these are basically coming in fourth quadrant, right? So here you can also say like pi by 2 minus x will always come in the first quadrant, because pi by 2 or 0 ke beech mein hoga, or pi by 2 plus x or pi minus x. So these angles basically coming in a specific quadrant based on which you can use the sign of, that is either it is plus or minus, you can use that one. See, cos of 180 plus x is directly you can write pi plus x and pi minus x are called even angles. Pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2 are called odd angles. See, इसको हम कहते हैं odd angles और इसको कहते हैं even angles. Remember, nothing else. Right, so already I have explained so many things based on even multiple and odd multiple in the last lecture, so you can use that one. So directly I would write here cos of 180 plus theta is minus cos x into cos of minus x is simple cos x upon sine of 180 minus theta is sine theta sine x. Cos 90 plus theta is minus sine x. So minus minus get cancelled. It reduces to cos squared. It reduces to sine squared. Hence now it reduces to cot squared over. So if you observe, basically I haven't used the formulas of compound angles because I am using the previous exercise concept to reduce this to LHS is equal to RHS. So it's my understanding whether I would like to go with this or I would like to go with the previous concepts. So it's completely depending on my understanding and relativity. Okay. So those who are able to relate the previous concept and the current concept, so they may use their understanding and they may use their creativity to reduce this question, to prove this question in smartest way. Okay. So other way is to solve is what? You may take each part as a single question. Like first you will take cos of pi plus x, first solve this value by using cos of x plus y identity, and then solve sin of pi minus x by using this identity, and then cos of pi by 2 plus x by using this identity, and then you can go for the substitution, then you will be able to get this expression. So there are several ways to use, several ways to prove one identity. That is why it's called open-ended topic. So wherever we are getting open-ended topic, students have a chance to explore their understanding and creativity. So it all depends how you are getting these concepts, how you are relating the previous formulas and the current formulas, previous identities and the current identities. It's completely based on your understanding and your interest. Okay, so no need to add it, just apply and just enjoy the concept. And in the same manner, I would insist everyone to complete this exercise till question number 10, that is 1 to 10. Please finish as a homework, right, from NCERT, including solved examples. Okay, so based on these six formulas, all the questions are framed, and please carry on and stay healthy, stay blessed, and we'll meet you in the next session, right, with the extension of these formulas. Thank you and bye-bye. See you.